Wanted: skiers comfortable in Alaska's Chugach Range, proficient in weather and snow sciences, certified in medical and rescue techniques, with legs like tree trunks, now hiring for the position of guide.
Big mountains, real time, real scenarios, and our number one focus is obviously to turn people onto the best day of their life. That usually transcends into, my God, that was the greatest week of my life. This is Disneyland on steroids. There's no place like it. Land of plenty.
Points North Heli Adventures in Cordova doesn't just feature the world's most intense terrain. It features a staff dedicated to making that terrain available to regular skiers and snowboarders.
The skiing in Alaska is truly like no other skiing in the world. I was addicted to Alaska and the feeling that it made me have right from the beginning. Being an Alaskan guide has so many amazing rewards, but it also comes with a ton of pressures too.
This is Alan Riley's sixth season guiding at Points North.
Coming up here, guiding people in these mountains, you know, these are big mountains and there's big consequences. Making a bad decision up here is not really an option. You're kind of reading and running as you go, and so there's a little stress involved with that for sure.
So thinking about skiing this face right here, boys, you guys can see all, it's pretty prominent, direct, top to bottom. There's a lot to learn, all from a life,
though, take what you want. You know, we go into varying circumstances not really knowing what we're going to get ourselves into, but knowing we have to be able to get ourselves out of that. Your only other backup is your fellow guide that's out there with you.
I feel really lucky with who we have because they're like a band of brothers to me. The Alzies and the Jimbos and the Kevins and the Kips and the J-Max. You don't have better people to learn the tricks of the trade by. And as I said, I feel really protected and lucky to be with such a tight-knit group of people out there when we're guiding, because really it's a family and we're all watching each other's back.
Jessica and Kevin Quinn have spent 11 years assembling one of the most respected guide staffs in the world.
You know, yeah, I have 15 other guys that I guide with. Does that matter to me? No, I love it. It's less maintenance. It's, you know, less drama, and the guys treat me like one of the guys, and I love having those guys out there in the field.
Not skiing over exposure until we see what that slough's doing. Good slough management skills today.
I play lead guide, but I believe in the idea of everybody being a lead guide.
Kevin earned his stripes in these mountains before guiding protocols were firmly established.
We fly in small groups, four and a guide. That guide is a leader in himself, and that guide goes out with a plethora of information. Lots and lots of communication and networking in the field with one another. Outside world doesn't understand how elaborate it really is.
You have a group that you are ultimately responsible for. You're responsible for getting them down safely, for their slough management, avalanches, route finding, for anything and everything. There's no room for I should have or I wish I had.
Longtime Points North skiers refer to Kip Gar as Kevin's go-to guide for rookies who talk a big game. He's good at creating some perspective. Notice that he's not stopping.
What people come to Alaska for is to ski that steep terrain, right? Start off on these mellower runs and they're really fun, and you get this just like this really cool feeling of skiing this terrain, and you always want to step it up and ski a little steeper terrain, a little steeper and a little steeper.
There's just so much terrain out here, you can never ski it all. You know, I could ski 300 different runs up here in a season, but there's always two or three that I just want to get to, I'm dying to get to.
No one at Points North gets onto faces like these before the guides do. Their job requires them to step carefully into the unknown, happily exposing themselves to unstable snow and deadly terrain. Through this process, the unknowable can become known by skiers and snowboarders like you. Didn't come to Alaska to be a guide. He came for the same reason as everyone else, the skiing.
The thing that keeps bringing me back is that just when you think you've probably skied everything out there, you go around the corner and you find a new run. Or suddenly you're out there a little bit later in the day and you get to ski some run in the tangerine light that you never got to do before. It's all about the magic moments that you find out there. You know, we all go back to our regular lives, and the best part about coming up here is how that fills the rest of your year. It's really, you know, life-fulfilling.
You're living and sleeping and eating and breathing with your fellow guides, all being good friends, great mates, great ski buddies, but number one, fellow guides out in the mountains.
There's a reason it's called the Super Bowl of skiing. It's just so massive and huge, and the mountains jet out all around you with lines dancing in front of your face. And it's truly a magical place that just, it leaves an imprint on your heart. And once you get hooked, you're hooked for life.
Along the way, Mac and all the Points North crew discovered a gift for not just exploring these mountains, but bringing others along with them, which is how they went from being skiers we admire to skiers we follow.
I think we're a serious crew up here. We have a serious good time, but we're serious about our job. When things are on the line, people have to be on their game, even though it is so much fun. Best job in the world.